Welcome back, viewers. How are we doing today? It's rainy, it's gloomy, but I hope your life is doing well, and I'm sending you all blessings and healing, love and light, because it is a hard world, isn't it? And we're all struggling. We're all trying to do the best we can do. We're all trying to be the best we can be. But before I continue with today's, the second part of the video, I want you to know, please, you know, hindsight is well and good. We can only react to a situation with the things that we are given. So don't be so hard on yourself. Anyway, let's get into it. Part 2, conversations with other people. Part 2 is continuing the conversation I had with the maintenance guy who helped plaster up the hole in my brick wall. And it was on relationships. Now, before I delve deep and meaningful into relationships, I want you to know that I watch MAFS. In Australia, MAFS, Married at First Sight, is all the rage. And that's how the second part of the conversation was going. I was catching up on last night's edition of MAFS, and we first started talking about why do people go into MAFS, and I said first that I would honestly go into MAFS because I'm looking for a everybody wants a relationship, everybody wants someone to be with. But before I go there, we believe that 80% of people on MAFS are not serious. They're just there for the fame. They're just there so that their name, whoever, whatever, gets on TV and, oh, we know you. You are on MAFS. And then we got to talking. And as I said in my first video, this man is 64. He's one of his sons is in his 30s and never going to have a relationship. It's just not for him. And I said that I had a son the same way. I said my son, my youngest, is 37. His last relationship was early 20s. He's never and is not interested because it's just too hard. Now, before I get into relationships, I want to tell you, I am not giving you relationship advice. In fact, I'm just sharing and talking about conversations we had and about a bit about my life. I was married 4 times. My 4th husband, as you all know, passed away in 2020. I've explained this many times, what happened to him. I'm still grieving. And you know, I've learned to accept that part of that grief is not having somebody. And that's what I always try and tell you, to cherish every moment, because when that's taken away from you, you realize how much you took that for granted, how much you miss it. And anyway, I said that I would like a relationship, and I would. And I said, dating apps. I tried dating apps. In fact, if you look up one of my videos, I go and vent about dating apps. I went on dating apps. And all the guys were interested in was taking me home for a casual, not even that, maybe a one-night you know, fling in the bed and see you later. And this 64-year-old maintenance man said to me, 65% of males, in his opinion, are a-holes. He said, they come home from a day of work, expect vodka on the table and their meals cooked. And that's true. I am trying to find a relationship. I met a guy not long ago and we had coffee because I'll give anything a go, but it was soon made quite clear. The first red flag for me was he said that he was separated from his wife, but they were still sharing the same home. Yeah, right, mate. You just want to fling on the side. And yes, there's nothing wrong with sex, but why do men put that so important? Why? And I think maths is the same. I think, you know, free sex, hey, you know? Now, sex is important, but wouldn't it be nice to have someone in your life that you can tell about your day, you know, deconstruct, vent, and someone just to hold you and love you and be there till your dying days, someone to hold your hand. It is very lonely being single. And as I shared quite, and this is the first time I ever, and then I realized it, talking to you now on the video, that I'm grieving Rob, but I'm not just grieving Rob, I'm grieving not being in a relationship. I'm grieving the loss of a man in my life. Just a funny thought, if you are intelligent, doesn't matter how old you are, and yes, looks are important. Let's be truthful. We are all shallow. When we first meet someone, we know whether we are attracted to them or not. In one relationship, this man was a good-looking man and could get any girl he wanted. But for some reason, I don't know what it was. It was something that put me off. And I'm being open and honest with you guys. And sex was quite infrequent. And I found out later, it was a smell thing. He was into doing weights. And when he started to sweat and have this release of pheromones, I didn't like it. Yet, the love of my life rarely showered because he was traumatized from a child, so he had hygiene issues, yet I loved his smell. That's Rob, the one who passed away. So, anyway, back to my funny little moment. If you are intelligent, if you are funny, if you're willing to put up with baggage, because like the maintenance man said, we all come with baggage. So if you're willing to put up with baggage, but you are there, solid, loyal, willing to give me a chance, leave a comment below. I'll give you my email address. gemamberstone@gmail.com. Yeah, I'm putting it out there because if you are alone, no one should be alone. Anyway, back to conversations with this maintenance man. He told me how his parents were still alive. His father was 93. I don't know how old his mother is, but wouldn't that be nice? Don't tell me that if you... I've been on my own there since 2020. And I don't like it. And truthfully, all I have is Sahara, my dog. I have got family, but they've got family, and their family comes first. My children have children, and their children comes first. So when Sahara, my dog, dies, I've got nothing. I hope I just roll over and die. So yes, I'm grieving, Rob, but I'm grieving not having a relationship, because however, whatever you want to believe in, whether you want to believe in God, whether you want to believe in, you know, that once there was this primordial soup and one cells, or you want to believe in aliens created us, or you want to believe this is a simulation game, whatever is irrelevant. What's relevant, and I'm just going to take homosexuality out of this for a moment, I'm just going to say that, and I'm, please forgive me, I believe, you know, if you're attracted to women and you're a woman, that's fine. If you're attracted to a man, and your man, that's fine. I've been there. I've been attracted to women, so we're all along that scale. All I am saying is that physically, that women, a woman was made, and physically, a man was made. And physically, a man fits a woman. You know, we're talking about jigs. I'm not going to get into biology or gender talk here, because I'm all for transgender and stuff like that. I'm just saying yin and yang, okay? Male and female. We were not, we're meant to be together. We're social animals. We're not meant to have isolation. Even if I was a lesbian, I'm not meant to be in isolation. Dogs, not meant to be in isolation. That's why Sahara, my dog, sees me. We're just the pack now, just her and I. Before that, there was her, Jimmy, her son, me, and Rob. But now we're down to two. And soon we're going to be down to one. She turned 11 yesterday. I'm 63. Now, yes, I had 17 years robbed as a drug addict. I'm clean. And if someone's willing to look past that and look into my heart, I've probably got 10 or 15 years of quality time that I could give to someone. So if there's someone who else is lonely out there, hi, see me. But anyway, the man, maintenance man, was asking me about this, and I was saying every time I put myself out there, all I get back is this sex. Now, I'm not saying sex isn't important. It is. But love, or at least fondness, should come first. You should have a solid liking of each other before intimacy. I don't care how many times you do it a day, but at least know the person you're with. Why, when I put myself out there just on looks, that, or just because they think I'm a lonely old woman, that, you know, night in the bed and I'll be good. So as I said, this isn't relationship advice. It's just conversations I had with my maintenance man, part two. All right, let me know, because as I said, we are not meant to live in isolation. If you do, and you're off the grid, and you're mentally sane, I bow my head to you, because I'm not mentally sane. And I'm getting worse every day. And I've got friends in their 80s who lost their husband the same time I lost mine, And they told me that they are so depressed. Do you know why we're depressed? Because one and one makes two. We need company. It is so lonely going to bed by yourself at night. No one to hold on to. No one to... Yes, relationships are hard. Relationships, you have arguments. It's not happily ever after. You have arguments. You butt heads. The maintenance man and I talked about this. You butt heads. It's a lot of hard work. But the rewards, aren't they worth it? We came here to play the human game. We came here to play the human game of connection, to connect to others, and to learn about love. With that, I'm done. Thanks for watching. No, I am not desperate. So if you are going to leave a comment to say, you know, oh, please be real. That's what I'm looking for, real, for lasting, as we all do. We don't want to fling. I don't want to be someone's mistress, someone's piece of meat on the side. And I said this to the maintenance man, and he said that there was this man who was also very rich, who was in his 80s, I think, and his wife died, and he had another friend who had a lot of female friends whose, you know, men had died. And the thing was that this man, who was very rich, instead of going and getting or wanting a relationship, he was paying money for prostitutes. He would rather have prostitutes. So I shared with the maintenance man that one day, I was 43, and I was walking along, and this car pulled up to give me a lift, and it was believe it or not, a 99-year-old man who right there and then propositioned me because his wife was on a cruise. Now, men, maybe that's, I'm not a man, so maybe no judgment. Hey, if that's what you want, go and pay your $200 or $300, whatever it is. And like I was saying, the maintenance man said to me, because of this, there were plenty of these women, but these women were too nice for this farmer, because all he wanted was to have sex. Women, they might look, you know, even the maintenance man said he watches, you know, the single shows because he's a man and women are good to look at. There's nothing wrong with looking at something pretty. But it's about respect and treating a woman right. And if you just see her as something to get your wet, you're no man, in my opinion. All right? So if you have got someone in your life, whether you are along that line of heterosexuality, whether you are gay, cherish that person. Love that person. Be loyal to that person. Please don't let them down. Don't go to your deathbed with remorse and regret. Don't think the grass is greener on the other side. There was a reason you were drawn to that person in the first place. And we were talking about that too. We were talking, maintenance man and I. I said, I've been a counsellor. And there's been people who've been married for 40 years and suddenly they say, I don't love him anymore. What the? 40 years, and suddenly you don't. That's emotional immaturity in my books. I've said my piece. Have a good day. Lots of love. Bye from me. And I probably won't be on tomorrow until I meet someone else, and it'll be another conversation, because I'm continuing to do a few videos called Conversations. Bye.